Welcome. What are we learning today? More electrical. To be specific, lesson number 2 on relays. The first lesson on relays showed you how relays work and how they are wired up. Now it's time to step it up a little bit and put our newfound knowledge to work. Let's go to the vehicle and see how important it is to understand how relays are wired and how to test them. Okay, let's see if we can put some of our newfound knowledge to work. Customer states that the AC does not work. Well, let's see what it does. Start the engine. Turn on the AC. Maximum cold. Medium fans good enough for me. I give it a few seconds. The air is blowing. I can feel the air blowing. If it wasn't blowing, well, that means there's a problem with the blower. No, there's not a problem with the blower. The AC is not cold. Let's go to my favorite place, the hood, under the hood. Come on. The first thing we're going to do is find the AC compressor. This particular one is not too bad. There's some that are easier and some that are more difficult. I want to turn our attention to this round disc in the front. It's called the AC clutch. We're going to start the engine. We're going to turn on the AC, and we're going to see if this clutch starts to spin. The engine is on. The AC is on. We are looking for the rotation of the clutch. We'll give it as much as 30 seconds. Usually it's about 10 seconds, but some vehicles take a while. This clutch is not engaging. The next thing we're going to do is to make sure we have enough refrigerant pressure to expect engagement. We need at least 40 pounds of pressure to expect engagement on most vehicles. Let's take a measurement. Everything seems to be easy so far on this vehicle. I'm going to remove the cap. These caps are very important. They can stop and prevent leaks, so I'm going to make sure I put this in a safe place. I don't need a big fancy gauge set. All I need is something to be able to measure the pressure. Here, I'm going to make sure my valve is turned off, and I am going to connect to the low side of the AC pressure. Let's see how much pressure I have. It looks like I have plenty. In fact, I've got over 100. It's very hot out there today. That affects the static pressure. The engine is off. The AC is off. I am measuring the low side pressure. I have plenty of refrigerant pressure. That is not the problem. The most common reason the compressor does not engage is because there's not enough pressure in the system. If it doesn't have at least 40, it will not engage. Let's go on. The next step is to do some electrical testing. Here's the box on this particular vehicle. Let's see if the friendliness continues. I take it off, and yes, there's some information inside. And yes, it says right here, MGCLT. That stands for magnetic clutch. They don't all call it that. Most of the Asians call it that. So yes, we have a relay. Which one is it? Well, I use it, I lay it out, and it's this relay. It's this relay right here. Now, the relays need a little help to be removed. One of the ways that I do it is to get a little leverage from my test light, and I start working it and working it and working it. The relay comes out. Here's my relay. I look at the relay, and the friendliness continues. Right here, I have two copper terminals. That tells me, identifies the load section. And then I have the other two terminals. They're a little bit smaller. This is a friendly relay. Let's put this in a safe place. The first tool I'm going to need is a simple 12-volt test light. I connect the alligator clip to negative. I make sure that my test light is ready to work. I might as well go to all four terminals. It takes 4 seconds to check four terminals. Let's see if I have anything to work with. Anything means positive voltage. Ready? Let's see if I can do four tests in 4 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4. I have no voltage. This is where the variation begins to take place. Sometimes there's voltage, sometimes there's not. I'm going to do 4 tests in 4 seconds. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4. I have two terminals that have power. This one is the larger copper terminal. Let's work it next. With the key in the on position, I have something to work with. Something means battery voltage, positive. Now I take this. This is a jumper wire. All I'm going to do is connect to the one that has positive, and on this particular circuit, I'm going to connect, disconnect, and hopefully I will hear the clutch. Let's see what happens. I hear it. Not only do I hear it, let me get my fingers out of the way, you might be able to see that small spark. Everything means something. I just did 2 tests without even touching the fuse. I tested it. Without even touching the wires going to the clutch, I tested it. I just tested half of the relay circuits. Let's go on. This one has positive with the key on. This is the control side of the relay. We're halfway done. The load section is good. Now it's time to check the control section. I just checked the positive side of the control section. Now it's time to check the negative side. Everything needs positive and negative, whether it be a blower motor, an injector solenoid, an ignition coil, a relay. To operate the relay, we need some positive and negative. I have the positive. Let's check the negative. What do? I reverse polarity. I take the negative, I take the alligator clip, I attach it to the positive side, I make sure my test light is ready to go, and I probe my last one. Now this is where the major variation takes place. This is where you have to understand each of the individual circuits. In this particular case, we're working with the AC clutch. The engine has to be on, the AC has to be on. There's usually about a 10 second delay, and then the light should turn on. Let's see if it does that. The engine is on, the AC is on. I'm waiting, I'm being patient. This light should come on. and it's not. What are we going to do next? Let's find out. The negative did not turn on. That is very common. Experience is a wonderful thing. Well, where does that negative come from? In most cases, on late model, that means the latest thing out, new, the computer is responsible for providing the negative. No, I'm not condemning the computer. The computer doesn't like something. In this particular circuit, the AC pressure sensors are at the top of the list. So let's go on. Any technician should agree that the number one tool they use all the time is a light. I call this light enhanced vision. You think you can see, but you need to see above average. What am I going to do? I'm going to perform an inspection. I'm looking on the AC hoses, the AC lines. I'm looking for some type of pressure sensor switch device. I don't see any over here. Let's see if I can find something over here. Ah, here's something. This is on the high side, and this is the sensor. I can tell it's a sensor because it has three wires, and what the heck? This thing is loose. I wonder what's going on. Well, heck, no wonder it doesn't work. This thing is not making good contact. The computer recognized a bad signal from the high pressure sensor and denied us engagement of the compressor. Let's put this guy back on, and I'm going to repeat the test now. I'm going to start the engine. My test light is still set up. I'm going to start the engine. I'm going to turn the AC on. There should be about a 5 or 10 second delay, and the light should come on. Let's see if that happens. Let's put the relay in and see if that fixed it. Let me start the engine. Yes, the compressor is on. And I know to touch this, and this is cold already. It's not always that easy. This is a very friendly vehicle. This particular sensor is very easy to get to. Some vehicles have the sensors inside the dash. That's a whole lot more trouble to get to. This is an example of how working around the relay can narrow the problem down. Let's see if we can finish up. Thank you for sticking around, and thank you for the view. I hope you learned how easy it can be sometimes to do most of the electrical tests that are involved with the relay. So many things can be checked at one location. Again, folks, thank you for the view. If you like the video, give us a thumbs up. If you learned something, hit that notice bell so we can keep you updated. And the most important thing, I hope you had a little bit of fun learning. That's our specialty. Thank you.